Hi again, everyone. I'm Ollie Matthews. This is Refuge from Narcissism, and this refugee video is sponsored by contribution from Anonymous, and here's his story. Hi, Ollie. Hope you're doing well there, mate. I want to briefly tell you my story about narcissism in boomers. Take my old man. I overhear him talking about millennials. Quote, millennials only have problems because they play too many video games. Yeah, they do. But why do they play too many video games? Because of the boomers. Who bought them the video games? Who bought them the gaming systems? Who lets them play it for hours and hours and hours? Who neglected them and doesn't pay attention when they're in these Discords or on these boards or in these groups or when they're online playing and you're not hearing the horrible shit that's being screamed back and forth. Those online games, you go into them, it's the worst fucking shit you've ever heard being yelled between each other. So he's right. They have problems because they play too many video games. But who bought the fucking video games? Who allowed it? Excuse me. Who designed them? Who designed them? Who was in charge when they started rolling this shit out? You were! Video games in this culture didn't just fucking sprout up like a fucking weed. It has a source. You! You, boomer, you're the source. You're the source of all this. Typical, no accountability from that generation. Clearly, who bought it? A little more lengthy anyway, take my workplace. I took a job a couple years ago. Started off as sole charge of doing sales and marketing, covering an area essentially equivalent to an entire medium U.S. state. Then it became, we can't hire any reliable delivery guys. Yes, because my workplace pays those roles like crap. So part-timing that. Oh, God, yeah. Well, look, I went through this at Macy's working in corporate, in a corporate environment for 19 years. They take no responsibility for the problems that they cause. And they used to, at Macy's, they used to have Gallup, Gallup poll, same company. They come in and they do surveys of your company to find out how happy the and content the employees are, what the areas are. Okay. And the first thing that they do, okay, with those polls is the best polling question and the worst polling issue. They throw out. They're not even discussed. Like, wait a minute. Wait a minute. So they even throw out the good with the bad. Because if it's good, it's the bad, which was always funding, staffing, money issue. Like this. They don't even want to fucking, that's everybody. That's the boomer, that's it. We don't want to talk about it. We just want to make up a straw man, you probably, because you're in that job or you're in that role. It must be your fault. Well, I don't decide what the fucking pay scale is. That's the boomer. That's the boomer in everything. Takes responsibility for nothing. For nothing. For nothing. That became, we can't hire any reliable delivery guys just because my workplace pays those roles like crap. So part-timing that. Oh, yes. So the parts person quit. So now you can handle it. So now I'm doing that as well. Typical entitled boomers sit around, yet they expect you to pick up everyone else's slack just because you do a good job. That's the problem. When a boomer knows you're good at something you do, they're going to ride that. They're going to ride you, okay? And devalue you at the same time. They will ride your talent and devalue you at the same time. to make you think you're not worth what you think you're worth. You're not doing the job that you're doing. And none of it's their fault. None of it is, even though they're the ones making the decisions that actually affect what's going on. Nope, nope, nope. Must be you. Must be you. Why hire more people when you could just keep dumping the responsibilities on your most reliable people? Talk about entitlement. Right, because probably what happens is their bonus structure, okay, their payouts are based on what they spend, what their budget, if they can come in under their budget. So now if they could come in X amount under their budget, that's all goes money right into their fucking pocket for their bonuses and their retirements and their fringes, for all their fringe benefits. They don't put any of that money back into the fucking job. All these boomers do is suck the resources out of everything they touch. What do they care if the company won't be around another 5 years? They'll be gone. They'll be gone with their benefits package. And when it goes and when it collapses, believe me, they'll be negotiated so they can keep all their retirement and all that. All that is all happens. All of that. Typical boomers don't think I got a dollar more pay raise for all my extra work either. Other bullshit. No, it had to go to their bonuses. Oh, well, I guess I'll have to find something better, but at least I have a story to share. Nerdy is all heck, but live long and prosper, guys. Not because it's TV, but because it's what the narcissists don't want for you. Thanks, Anonymous. Well, it's what the boomers don't want for you. The boomer doesn't want you to know your true value ever, 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 because they live in a world of smoke and mirrors, of leeching, of grifting. That's the boomer. That's the boomer. And if you ever step out and realize that they're full of shit, they lose all of their power. If Gen X and the millennials and Gen Y would just stand up together and say, enough of you fucking people. Enough. You've robbed all our resources for yourselves. You've maxed out the housing market. You fucking maxed out any tax money through your fucking lifetime pension funds and your Cadillac health plans. They just did something with Social Security here where they maxed out their benefits and then cut it off for everyone else behind them. Just shut the fucking door. They don't care because nobody has been able to stand up to stop them. Because nobody has stood up. I mean, there's a few of us out there and you hear it from time to time. Okay, boomer. Okay, boomer. Okay, no, but they have not been held accountable. These countries that do these austerities, where they're seizing people's bank accounts, they're taking 30, 40, like they did in Greece, okay? I have no problem with that, but do it from the boomers' accounts. Do it to the university systems that have billions and billions and billions in their escrows. Billions and billions in their endowments. Seize the endowments. Why? Who created it? Who created those endowments? The boomers. They expanded exponentially under the boomers. Under the boomer communist control. The boomer never wants you to realize your value. Because once you do, the jig is up for them. It's over. It's over, and rightfully so. Will they ever realistically face justice for what they have done to society? No, they'll die off before then. The only justice to them would be an accurate recounting of history, of how fucking toxic and destructive and narcissistic that generation is and was. Hopefully soon was. Will be was. They don't want you to know your value because they're living off everyone else's talent. And they take zero responsibility for anybody's mistakes. That's the boomer. You get to live off of everyone else's talents and then blame the same people for all your mistakes. Ain't that a bitch? So, I hope that helps. Thank you so much, Anonymous, for your contribution and story. I really appreciate it. Thank you to everybody watching. Please leave any opinions or advice in the comment section below. And again, if you want your story read on the channel, you have a topic you'd like me to cover, something you'd like me to expose, you'd like to set up a Skype, a phone call, have a private video made, you'd like to sponsor a video like this for someone who needs help and can't afford it, or just make a contribution to the channel in general to keep it supported, growing, and successful, because this channel survives 100% on contributions from all of you. Without you guys, all of this goes away. So if you like what you see here and you want to see more videos like this, you know what to do with the PayPal and email links in the description box. Also, please like and share this video wherever you can. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't, and be sure to click the subscription bell to be notified of all my video uploads. I'm Ollie Matthews. This has been Refuge from Narcissism. Take care.